Well, blessings, everyone who's listening in, in that special time, place, where you are. And actually, we're coming to you live from the presence of God. Isn't that amazing? We can actually transmit now a realization about who we are, where we are, and what we're capable of. And that's what the radioactive ascension really is all about. Is a work of a transmission of eternal ideas and wonderful realizations about what we are, what we really are, beyond appearances, and what we're capable of as God-born beings. Not just physical beings, God-born, born of spirit, born of fire, water. Our ascension is our conscious ascension back up and into a realization that the presence of God is all around us. It's always been here. It's always been this way. This is why the message is eternal. This realization changes everything and means each of us can now actually begin to live this realization on earth as it is in heaven. That is to say, connecting the highest spiritual aspects of your being on earth right now into that which even transcends the earth. That's why I can say this message coming to you is coming to you actually live from within the kingdom of God. And this means we no longer have to wait upon time, waiting for 2012 or 2020, or waiting for a second coming, or a third coming, or spaceships to come. No, we're already here. Some of us are gaining this realization at the depths of our being, at the heights of our being, at the depths completely surrounding us in this realization, this canceling of time, because we don't need to wait anymore. Why? Because grace cancels time. And we really are already in the kingdom of God. This is the way it's always been. Our fall, if there ever was a fall, was only our fall inward and downward into the feelings of isolation and separation from all that life is, all that God is. Our ascension is our ascension back up into that knowingness of a oneness. Love connects us to the truth. Love connects us to the truth of it. And ever so gently, love connects us back up and into all that God is. And this is what we're learning. We're learning directly from God by way of expanding our realization about being in the presence of God. Many thousands of individuals are getting this message now on earth. We are now, right now, in the process of finding those who are willing to teach this message of God's presence on earth. God incarnate on earth. God incarnate overall. In you all. And in reality, God becomes another word for all there is. This is why I'm calling you citizens of heaven. All of you are not just citizens of this country or that. But all of you are citizens of heaven. And this is what we're coming forward with, being able to live on earth for a time, for whatever, another 150 years. However long you want to live on earth and be in heaven at the same time, because all this death business of having to die to get there has always been a bunch of baloney. This is why I'm calling you citizens of heaven. I'm talking to you. So what does it really mean to be a teacher in the new age? And what are the new methods for getting the eternal message out? as I was asking myself this question this week, I saw myself standing at the bottom of a gigantic snow-covered mountain. Ooh, it was a big mountain, too. And wondering, how does one get to the top of such a mountain? If you look, it seems all uphill, rather cold. But you know what I began to hear? I began to hear the sound of a helicopter. And I knew what is coming forward are new and miraculous ways to get to that top of that mountain. And with that, I'd like to introduce you just a tiny bit in a wonderful way to a dear heart friend of mine, a new age avatar, in fact. And I can call him that because in my heart, he is that already. There's no need for an ego about it, because what we are, we're all incarnations of God. And Lincoln is really carrying this forward, not just in his ego. He does have a little ego. We all got a little ego. But he's carrying this forward with grace in this world. A true citizen and messenger of heaven. So with that, I'd like to introduce you. Say hi to my dear friend, Lincoln Gerger. Hi, Lincoln.
Hello, Charles. Thank you
for
that.
How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for that heartwarming introduction. I'm very happy to be here and to speak out to the radioactive community and to share my own perspective on living in the kingdom of heaven with all of you. Because as Charles has said, in reality, we're already there. We just simply need to recognize it and remove all these limited beliefs that tell us otherwise.
I really do believe that. I really do believe that. It wasn't anything new that Jesus discovered when he announced the kingdom of heaven on earth 2,000 years ago, or with any of the great prophets. It's the eternal truth. This is the way it's always been. We need to kind of like wake up like Buddha. Wake up.
Yeah, that is true, Charles. And that the truth always is. We just sometimes forget to look at it.
Yeah, that's very true, too. That's very true, too. Mm-hmm. So our question this evening, what does it mean to be a teacher in the New Age? And how are we getting, what are the new methods we can use to get this eternal message out to everybody? Kind of like, you know, wake up, we're already here, this is it, this is it. You know what I mean? How can we help to show this better to the world? Get it out there. What do you think? What do you think, Lincoln?
Well, my own practice is embracing the wonderful internet. Through the internet, we can get our voice all around the world in a matter of seconds. Anybody who's interested can type in their keywords on Google and find what is appropriate for them at their current stage of spiritual understanding and spiritual evolution. So it's really quite unique in that our spiritual teachers can really be delivered to our doorstep. We don't have to hike mountains. We don't have to leave our families and our friends. We can really bring this knowledge anywhere we are, to our cell phones, to our personal computers. So quite interestingly, the New Age is always with us. The spiritual teachings can always be with us, and we don't have to go out anymore. And that brings us to, interestingly, the deeper truth that's happening now in humanity is that the spiritual truth is always with us because it is us. It's within us. It's every part of our being. And by just increasing our awareness about what is happening in the present moment, what's going on in our bodies, our minds, what's going on in our heart, what's going on in our consciousness, that's how we really awaken and we become our own teacher. And we realize that everyone is a teacher for everyone else, and every moment is a teacher for us, and we are living the teacher.